Composite Brush is a high-precision color selector and modifier for After Effects. You click and drag over the colors that you want, then you alt-click and drag over the colors that you don't want, and the plugin makes a precise selection based on your input, then modifies with the transfer mode. You can change the color right in the plugin using hue, saturation, and lightness, or use a handful of familiar transfer modes. Here's some stock footage that was clearly not shot with keying in mind. So if you try to key this using key light, maybe you can do it if you really know how to use these controls, but it's going to be difficult. With Composite Brush, just click and drag the areas you want to key, then alt-click and drag the areas that you want to preserve, and you get a pretty good key with minimal effort. Here's a shot that you may look at and see these semi-transparent colors and think you can probably get a pretty good key using key light. And to a point, maybe you can. However, you're going to notice in some of these dark areas, there's going to be a lot of flickering and chattering. Now, I can't pretend I know exactly how key light works or why this is happening, but I do know that Composite Brush is very careful about how it interpolates between colors. So if we grab Composite Brush here, we're going to click here to designate as opaque. Then we're going to alt-click here to designate semi-transparent and set the transfer mode to silhouette alpha. And you'll notice there isn't any flickering in there. It's a very smooth and careful falloff. Another thing that's nice about Composite Brush is just looking back at this original image. If we decided that we want this jellyfish's brain to be opaque too, then we can just click on it to designate it as opaque. Here's a shot with tons of spill. This was actually shot in such a way that we could bring out these really aggressive reflections to evaluate how different spill suppressors work. So if you take a look, there are some very good spill suppressors in After Effects already. The advanced spill suppressor is probably the best of them, set to ultra mode. And this does look great. However, you'll notice it's making the background gray and the reflections gray. So if we zoom in here, there's all these green reflections on this saxophone that we'd probably want to be this gold color. And the spill suppressor is seeing that these are similar to the green and it's graying them out. Composite Brush works in a very different way. If we want to target this specific area and change it to match the saxophone, just click and drag here. Also here, and then alt-click and drag over the colors that you want to preserve. And you probably want to get all the greens in the background too, just for good measure. And then just go to the transfer mode color, and set it to the color of the saxophone. And maybe use the hue transfer mode. And you can just further refine by swiping over these other areas that are still green, towards the edge of the hand here. And you can see this is a very targeted and aggressive spill suppression. It allows you to directly select the colors that you want to modify, like these greens, which are very similar to the greens in the green screen, and change them to exactly the color you want. While we're at it, let's key this using Composite Brush, clicking and dragging the colors that we want to remove, and then alt-clicking and dragging the colors we want to keep. Now you'll notice that it got rid of this spill, so again, just alt-click here to bring that back. And we'll set this transfer mode to Stencil Alpha. So let's take a look at that with and without spill suppression. It looks a lot better. Some of you may be looking at this and wondering, how did we pull a key if the saxophone is this golden color and this green screen is now this golden color, and this effect here is seeing both of those golden colors, and yet keying this as if it's looking at the original image which had green in it? Well, that's because whenever we use Composite Brush, it ignores all the effects before it, and it actually is keying the original image, which had the green in it. So the cool thing is that these layers can be ordered and moved around any way you want without any consequence. And just to prove this concept, let's go and grab a black and white filter. So for example, here, this is black and white. You obviously couldn't pull a color key here, and yet this effect is still working and keying correctly. Where this is really cool is if you want to append to an existing key. So let's say that we keyed this with key light. And we're having trouble preserving these spill areas that are very green and keeping them opaque. And let's put a spill suppressor on it too. So I'm just going to go to immediate results and add the advanced spill suppressor. So you can grab composite brush, click and drag these colors that you want. I'll click and drag the colors that you don't. I'll be saying that often. And there's a transfer mode here, increase alpha. And that's just going to bring back the areas that you've keyed out. That's looking good. And again, if you want to further tweak this spill, you can do that, even though there are a bunch of effects coming before Composite Brush that are changing the colors from the original clip. I really want to drive home the point of how useful it is that you can stack as many of these effects on top of each other as you want. Imagine a situation where you have a rendered video, you received it, you don't have the layers, and you have to swap these colors. So this blue will become yellow, yellow will become pink, and the pink will become blue. The typical way to do that would be using an effect like change to color, and that's pretty easy to do, but of course I'll run into the problem here, where if you want to change the star color next, then it's going to change the color of the robe because it's looking back to this previous effect and seeing that they're both the same color. So the alternative to this would be to key the layer separately and do this three times with three separate layers and three separate keys. This is more work than it should be, and a lot messier too. With Composite Brush, we can do this pretty quickly. I'll use the normal transfer mode. And I'll continue the same process. Clicking the star, alt-clicking the colors that aren't the color of the star. Moving on to the glove. And for good measure, I'll preserve the color of the lines by using one last instance, where I'll select the black, and then I'll click each of these areas. And with only four instances of Composite Brush, I can swap around this palette without having to use multiple layers. That's all for now. Check out Composite Brush at aescripts.com.